Christians long ago, who were brought before a tyrant's throne, they were told that he would spare their lives if they would renounce the name of Christ. Then one by one they chose. Son of God, they would not deny, like a great angelic choir sings. I can almost hear their voices ring. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb with all my strength, with all.
Well, son, from the beginning, men hated Jesus. Even though he did nothing but love them, and teach them, and heal them, they still nailed him to a cross. They thought they had killed him, but they only freed him to live in the hearts of people like you and me who believe in him. Then came the apostles, and most of them were killed simply for telling other people about Jesus. But the church kept right on growing, watered by the blood of Jesus and inspired by the sacrifice of so many saints who gave their lives.
But did they want to die?
No, they didn't want to die. I mean, many of them had children just like you that they had to leave behind. But they were forced to make a choice. They could choose to live a life on this earth, reject Jesus and be condemned, or they could believe in Jesus and live forever.
I think I understand.
Just so you understand it a little bit better, why don't we start from the very beginning?
Voices ring. This night of nights has come to bring the world the long-awaited King. The earth is filled with sadness, and yet the heavens. For heaven's eyes can see. from above.
Yes, from the riches of heaven came Jesus, the Son of the living God. Jesus, the only begotten Son of the Father, would become the supreme sacrifice for sin. He and he alone would purchase the souls of men. The price would be paid in full on Calvary, where he, God's Lamb, would be viciously slaughtered. His cross overshadowed his cradle. He was born to die. Death, however, would hold our Lord but for a few days. For then, just as sure as yesterday has passed, Jesus would rise again. As his story unfolds, we see crowded streets, for the city of Jerusalem is filled with excitement. It's the Passover season. Everyone seems to be talking about this Jesus, a prophet from Nazareth. A triumphant march is heard as he majestically walks through the crowd. Listen, and if you listen further, you'll hear the people thronging the way, saying, "Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
They followed him down dusty roads, wherever he would lead. Multitudes would gather as he healed each disease. With eyes of wonder, they would watch as he would stop to pray. And when he spoke the words of faith, you could hear them say, here comes a miracle, here comes a miracle. Can't you feel it in the air? That look is on his face, his glory is in this place, and I know a miracle is near. The lame could walk, the deaf could hear, blinded eyes could see. Those who had been bound for years were suddenly set free. Came in desperation, the hurting and the poor. And when they saw him through the crowd, they knew what was in store. Here comes a
this curse. on the verge of simply giving up, not knowing what to do. All her hopes were cruelly shattered. It seemed her life was through. Then she heard a commotion, people talking in the streets. They said, someone is coming, it's Jesus the Nazarene. They said that he could heal the sick and cause the blind to see. She wondered in her heart, could he do the same for me? She began to make her way down the road to where he was, and though the crowd was pressing, she refused to give up. She reached out to touch his clothes for healing to impart. She not only touched his hip.
Who touched me?
She touched his heart. She touched the heart of Jesus. Satan had control. She found in her faith a brand new place to start. She not only touched his hem, she touched his heart. Without faith, she would have never seen beyond her need. But she chose to trust.
Martha, Mary, his sister's Lazarus.
John, what is it? What does it say?
I don't know.
What is it, Lord? Is something wrong?
Let us go into Judea again.
But Master, but we were in Judea before. The people, they tried to stone and kill you.
That's right.
Are you sure you want to go there again?
That's right.
Lazarus is dead. But I'm glad for your sakes that I was not there. so ye may believe more freely. Nevertheless, let us go unto him.
Let us also go and die with our master.
Mary, you must eat something. It's been 4 days. We're so worried about you. Mary, you just can't go on like this. You're going to mourn yourself into the grave. Mary, please talk to us.
Oh, Jesus. Where are you, Jesus?
Jesus? Jesus is coming. Martha, Jesus is coming.
Jesus?
Yes.
He is coming?
Yes.
Oh, Lord, if you would have been here, my brother would not have died.
Your brother shall rise again.
I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection of that last day.
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Do you believe this?
Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Excuse me, Lord, I must go find Mary. Mary, Mary, the Lord has come and he calls for you.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord, if only you had been there, my brother would not have died. Oh, Lord.
Where have you laid him?
Come, Lord, and see.
Oh, Jesus.
Lord, Lazarus is buried here.
Take away the stone.
But, Lord, he's been dead for 4 days.
Did I not say that if you would believe, you should see the glory of God? Father, I thank you that you heard me, and I know you hear me always. But for the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that you have sent me.
The crowds have lined the narrow streets to see this man from Galilee. Just a carpenter, some say, leading fools astray. Yet many kneel to give him praise. And in his eyes they glimpse the power that sees the hearts of all men. For he knows his Father's mind, he speaks his Father's words, for he comes
Lazarus,
in the name
come forth.
Of the Lord. Just depend on you and the power of your name.
call upon your name, your strength through weakness to show. We can know the Master's plan, extend the Master's hand when we come in the name of the Lord. There is strength in the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of the Lord. There is hope in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. His name will be worshipped forever. Creator, Redeemer, and King. There is strength in the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of the Lord. And there is hope in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes. Blessed is he who comes. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The name of the
Yes, this Jesus of Nazareth, the son of a carpenter, truly must be the Messiah, the prophesied promise, who has come to heal the sick, raise the dead, and save the lost. But just as he was loved by so many, he was also despised by others. The chief priest and his council plot against the Lord Jesus Christ. Their plan to eliminate his threat to their government has begun.
Caiaphas! Did not this Jew think himself to be of great authority, casting us out of our temple, overthrowing our treasury?
By what right does he do these things? And who gives him such authority?
The multitudes say that he's a prophet, the son of God. He looks only to be a deceiver to me.
This man Jesus speaks in parables against us to the people. He's dividing the people against themselves and us as well.
He deceives the people. He's just a man, yet he claims to be God. He speaks blasphemy.
This man is no God. He performeth miracles, not caring that it is a Sabbath day.
He a devil? He's just a man. He's mad. Why do the people even listen to him?
What do we do? For this Jesus of Nazareth does seem to perform many miracles.
Oh, trickery, trickery.
That's all it is.
It's trickery. Let us take him by trickery. Yes. And then kill him.
Kill him, yes, kill him.
Yes, but not on the feast of the Passover, lest there be an uproar amongst the people. We must act quickly. For if we leave this Jesus alone with the people, they'll believe on him. Then the Romans will come and take both our place and our nation.
Hear me, scribes. Do you know nothing at all? Know you not that it was prophesied that one man should die for the people? Let it be Jesus of Nazareth fulfills this prophecy and dies for that nation.
Yes. Let us send spies unto him that they might trick him with questions, appearing to be one of his followers. then we can deliver him under the power and the authority of the governor.
Governor?
Yes,
governor. We need someone who can get close to this Nazarene. Someone who can deliver him unto us.
Judas.
Yes, Judas Iscariot.
Yes, he's their treasurer.
Yes, he's one of his old disciples. He loves money. He can be bought for a price.
Yes,
there he is.
Judas.
Let us
Welcome
speak
to the
him.
Temple, Judas.
Jesus and his disciples, except for Judas, went out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus stopped at the entrance of a garden called Gethsemane. There he told them to watch and pray, as he went on to pray also. Twice he returned to find them sleeping, and finally the agony of his burden was so great that he let them take the rest. And he returned to pray alone.
To pray, his heart it broke in two. Then when Jesus had returned, he found them there asleep. They couldn't do one simple thing that he asked them to do. And he said, just 1 hour of your time is all I ask of you. To watch for me is my heart, it breaks in two. Just 1 hour of your time I've come to give my life, and all I ask is just 1 hour of your time.
Father, if thou art willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done.
If 1 hour of your time the Savior were to ask, could you find the time for him to freely remember just how long he said he'll have to hang upon the cross to save your life. Don't make him have to say, just 1 hour of your time is all I ask of you. For me as I intercede for you, just 1 hour of your time I've come to give my life, and all I ask is just 1 hour of your time.
Oh my Father, if this cup may not pass from me except I drink it, thy will be done. Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee.
Just 1 hour of your time is all I ask of you. To watch for me as I intercede for you. Just 1 hour of your time I've come to give my life, and all I ask
thou wilt. Behold, the Son of Man is betrayed in the hand of sinners. Rise up, let us go. He that betrays me is at hand.
Greetings, Master.
Judas, would you betray the Son of Man with a kiss? No, Peter! Put away your sword!
Are you the Christ?
If I told you, you would not believe.
You should not speak to the high priest that way.
If I spoke in evil, bear witness of evil. But if good, why do you strike me?
Is there any witness of this man's wrongdoings?
Yes, tell us.
This man is said he can destroy the temple of God and then rebuild it in 3 days.
Why would he destroy our temple?
Have you nothing to say? What is it which these witnesses bring against you? I charge you by the living God that you tell us whether you are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
It is as you say. Nevertheless, I say unto you, from hereafter you shall see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven.
He is spoken first for me.
Behold, you have heard this blasphemy. What do you think?
Jesus of Galilee.
Woman, you don't know what you're talking about.
You were with the Nazarene. I saw you with his disciples as you preached upon the mount.
I do not know him.
Why do you deny him? Not only did I see you cut the soldier's ear off in the garden, but twice I heard you say you don't know him. You lie. Are one of his disciples.
You filthy swine. You don't know what you're talking about. Master, I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry.
Thought I was so wise. Surely you can never see inside this darkness. I thought that I had fooled you. Now I see I was the fool, thinking I could hide this darkness in my heart.
Yes, first Judas, expecting to gain a worldly advantage, bargained with the chief priests to betray Jesus, the compensation being 30 pieces of silver, the price of a slave. Our Lord had declared him to be the traitor at the Last Supper. After earning his fee in the Garden of Gethsemane, he awakened to his enormous guilt, went again to the chief priests to confess his sin and return the money. When they mocked him, he cast the bag of coins at their feet and went out and hanged himself.
Because others have said it.
Am I a Jew? Your own nation, the chief priests, have delivered you unto me. What have you done?
My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight, that I would not be delivered unto the Jews. But now, my kingdom is not from here.
Are you a king then?
Thou sayest I'm a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness of the truth. Everyone that's of the truth hears my voice.
What is truth? I find no fault in him.
He stirs up the people, teaching lies unto all the Jews.
I find him guilty of nothing worthy of death. I will scourge him and then release him.
If you release him, you're no friend of Caesar.
Away with him! Away with him!
We have but one king, Caesar.
Take him and try him under your own law.
Governor, you know I cannot put anyone to death without your signature.
Give us your signature! It is a custom, as you know, at this time of your Passover, that we release unto you a prisoner, showing him mercy. We have a murderer named Barabbas.
release unto you either of these? Do you want me to release unto you the King of the Jews? Yes!
Away with this man! Release unto us Barabbas!
Give us Barabbas!
Barabbas!
But Barabbas is a murderer!
Release unto us Barabbas! Crucify Jesus!
No! Crucify!
Crucify! Why? What evil has he done? No! I will scourge him! Guards, prepare!
Calvary, Calvary,
Was it meant for him? Was it meant for me? Calvary, Calvary. Is that my cross he's taking to Calvary?
He found me in my sin.
walking on the road to Jerusalem. The time had come to sacrifice again. My two small sons, they walk beside me on the road. The reason that they came was to watch the Lamb. Daddy, Daddy, what will we see there? There's so much that we don't understand. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. Something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers, no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. Then I heard the crowd cry out, crucify! Father, forgive them,
You say you trust in God. Where's your God now?
Make sure this one's dead.
My spirit, he prayed, and then he died. I stood for what seemed like years. I'd lost all sense of time until I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the older say, "Father, please forgive us. The lamb ran away." Daddy, Daddy, what have we seen here? There's so much that we don't understand. So I took them in my arms, and we turned and faced the cross. And then I said, "Dear children, watch the Lamb."
The Son of God now hangs suspended between earth and sky, his lifeless form so marred that it defied description. Yet just 1 week ago, Jerusalem was as it were, shaken to its very foundation as the multitude shouted praises to his name. Now betrayed, denied, forsaken, he dies alone. Having lost his only worldly possession, his robe, he is laid to rest in a borrowed tomb.
Stripped you bare, the eyes that mocked and stared, the laughter everywhere, each stripe they made, the needles running red, the nails, the fight, the breath, the gaping door of death, the awful taste. Enraged against the silence in the sky. But when you asked for God to tell you why, you thought of us. Still had paradise,
nothing to say. And they were coming to take me away. When a voice from heaven was heard that said, "Oh, let him go, take me instead." Oh, I should have been crucified. Oh, I should have suffered to die. Oh, I should have hung on that cross in disgrace. Oh, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place. This crown of thorns, a spear deep in his side, and all his pain, oh, it should have been mine. Oh, those rusty nails were meant for me. Oh, but Christ took them and he let me go free. Oh, I should have been crucified. Oh, I should have suffered, should have died. Oh, I should have hung on that cross in disgrace. But Jesus, God's Son, took my place. Oh, Jesus, God's Son, yes, Jesus, God's Son. Oh, Jesus, God's Son, took my place. Thank you, Jesus, for taking my place.
It was the third day following the crucifixion of their Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The disciples and his loved ones have tried to pick up the pieces of their shattered lives. The death of their Lord had left an emptiness in their broken hearts. However, just as the Savior had promised them, the guards could not keep him, the grave could not hold him, and Satan could not defeat him. The Lord and Savior, the crucified Lamb of God, will rise again.
Not a word was heard at the tomb that day. Just the shuffling of soldiers' feet as they guarded the grave. One day, 2 days, 3 days had passed. Could it be that Jesus had breathed his last? Or could it be that his Father had forsaken him?
sun, and he said, "Arise, my love, arise, my love. The grave no longer has a hold on you. No more death sting, no more suffering. Arise, arise, arise."
The earth trembled and the tomb began to shake. Like lightning from heaven, the stone was rolled away. The guards as dead men just stood there in fright as the power of love displayed its might.
And suddenly a melody filled the air, riding wings of love, it was everywhere. The words all creation had been longing to hear, the sweet sound of victory, so loud and clear.
Arise, my love, arise, my love, the grave no longer has a hold on you, no more death sting, no more suffering. Arise, 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 arise,
is rising, and we must get to the Lord's tomb to anoint his body.
But how will we move the great stone? Suppose the soldiers will not let us pass.
Where is your faith?
Mary, look.
Be not afraid. Ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified.
Yes.
But he is not here. He has risen from the dead and goes into Galilee. There you shall see.
Yes. We must go and tell the disciples. Come quickly.
What is it, Mary? What is wrong?
I have wonderful news for you and the others.
Mary, what are you saying?
We had gone to the tomb at sunrise to anoint the body of the Lord, but he wasn't there. He has risen, just like he said he would. We were met there by an angel sent from God. He said we would find the Master in Galilee.
Speaks the truth. He's not here. Surely he's risen just like he said.
But John, didn't we witness his death? We saw him hang and die on the cross. We placed his body in this very tomb.
But Peter, the tomb is empty. There's nothing in there but his grave clothes. He's alive.
Darest we believe that such a great thing has come to pass?
No, I will not believe this. So in his hands I see the prints of the nails and put my fingers in those prints.
Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I'd promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. Even if he was alive, it just wouldn't be the same. Suddenly the air was filled with a strange and sweet perfume. Lights that came from everywhere drove shadows from the room. Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide. I fell down on my knees and just clung to him and cried. He raised me to my feet, and as I looked into his eyes, love was shining out from him like sunlight from the skies. Guilt in my confusion disappeared in sweet relief. And every fear I'd ever had just melted into peace.
Son, you got to remember, it wasn't always this way. I mean, my dad could pray in school. Of course, they took that away from him. And after that, they just stripped our right to worship away from us. And we quietly stood by and did nothing. And son, I hope that you're never put in a position where you have to choose between your faith and your life. But I know if you are, I know the choice you'll make. Because I know that Jesus lives within you.
Eric Richards,
Yes, Richard.
Sir, you're under arrest for publicly proclaiming the name of Jesus Christ. Turn around, put your hands behind your back.
Son? Son, you remember how I taught you to pray. Take care of your mother. Remember, God is a father to the fatherless.
And I saw a great white throne and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were opened, and another book was opened, which was the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. And whosoever was not found written in the Lamb's book of life was cast into the lake of fire, prepared for the devil and his angels.
Records show you worked hard all of your life. You were a devoted father and loving husband. You also donated much time and money to worthwhile charities. However, because of your humanistic values, you saw no need for a savior, seeking the pleasures of life and the praise of men, denying the existence of God.
As it is written, whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father, which is in heaven. I do not know you. Depart from me.
Sarah Logan. The records show that you claim to be a born-again Christian. You attended church regularly, sang in the choir, and even taught Sunday school. Indeed, you played the Christian role well. However, it was really just an act. You were the willing victim to one of Satan's greatest lies, believing that being raised in a Christian home and being an active member of the local church was enough to assure your home in heaven. How sad to say that you have dismissed the gospel of Jesus Christ, and how that he is the only door through which you may enter into heaven. You may have fooled others, and perhaps even yourself, but God looks upon the heart.
You are not one of mine. I never knew you.
No, no! Everyone who knew me thought I was saved! They all thought I was saved! Not that now!
Ricky Sanders. It is recorded that you lived a selfish life. You saw to it that your every fleshly desire in life you obtained at any cost, even if it caused many people pain. You polluted the minds and souls of your friends and peers with your many perversions. Therefore, hell has enlarged its borders to receive you and the many you have led astray. You once said you had no fear of God, making mockery of him and all those who believed on him. Look now upon the one you crucified.
You are cursed in the everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Give him his portion.
I was wrong! I believe in you now! Give me another chance! Please, God! No!
It is true. In the end, each person will stand alone on that judgment day. The Bible warns us in Hebrews, saying, "It is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul?" However, the scripture also speaks of another judgment. In Corinthians we read, "For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. To whom much is given, of him much shall be required."
William J. Murray, you were raised in an atheistic home filled with rage and violence. In fact, your own mother single-handedly and successively crusaded to have prayer removed from the public schools of an entire nation, stating that to pray in school would be a violation of separation of church and state, misquoting your founding fathers and calling it freedom from religion. You were raised in an atmosphere of non-belief and hatred for God and his principles. In spite of all of this, on January 28, 1980, you felt led in your heart that there was something more than the lies that you were raised on. You bought a Bible, and you willingly allowed the Holy Spirit to move on your heart and life as you accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior. You then took your faith one step further and obeyed God's call on your life to become an evangelist of the gospel, sacrificing your own life to undo the damage caused by the one who was created to teach you about Jesus, but had failed you.
"Whosoever shall lose his life for my sake shall find it. Enter in, my beloved one. Well done."
Cassie Bernal, as a young girl, you were raised in a loving home with loving parents, but there came a time when they could no longer control your teenage whims and rebellion. Worried and concerned for the daughter that they loved, and taking a firmer stand, they prayed and left you in the hands of God. Invited by a friend, you eventually began to attend church youth group meetings, and it was there that you found Jesus Christ. You spent the rest of your short life on earth telling all of your friends how Jesus had forgiven you and of the sacrifice that he made for them. Right up until the very moment when an angry student pointed a loaded gun in your face and asked you if you believed in God, and you boldly said yes. It was then he took your life. But the one thing he could never take from you was the love that your Savior has for you.
"Come in, my child. You fought a good fight. You've kept the faith. Enter into the joy of the Lord."
Eric Richards, it is written that you were raised in a good home with parents that taught you decent moral values. Sadly, they believed in being a good person was all they needed to assure their place in heaven. Therefore, they saw no need to attend church. So they sent you on the bus each Sunday alone. It was through the concern of a loving Sunday school teacher that you realized and accepted that Jesus Christ was the only door to eternal life in heaven. As an adult, you vowed to God to raise your son in church and to never refrain from telling him everything about God's love and the sacrifice he made for him on the cross. However, as moral decay ran rampant in the earth, laws were made that would forbid any such conversations outside of the privacy of your own home. Was your dedication to the promise that you had made to answer any question, any time, that resulted in your eventual arrest? Your earthly body died in a filthy prison, hungry, sick, and diseased. But not alone, as God himself sent a host of angels to escort you here.
Welcome home, my son. Your faith has been rewarded. Because of your love for me, many have come. You have your new body and your new white robe. There is someone waiting anxiously to see you.
Yeah. Dear friend, what you have seen is a true portrayal of God's love for you. Death is certain. The Bible tells us that each one of us will die, and after this, the judgment. You will be judged according to your relationship with Jesus Christ. Do you know him as your personal Savior? You can accept him by simply giving him your life and receiving him into your heart. You can do that right now. Allow me to lead you in a simple prayer. Pray with me. Dear Lord, I know that I'm a sinner, and I believe that you died to pay the penalty for my sins. Thank you for taking my punishment. Please come into my heart. I'm giving you my life. Help me to live for you. Amen. If you just prayed that prayer and accepted the Lord as your Savior, please call us or write to us here at Charity Baptist Church. Our number is 734-282-4626. We'll be glad to talk to you about your decision to trust Christ.